Hello, so let's get started with the alphabets, how to type them. And this is a remake of my old video, which was for the FX96 SG Plus. And there are a few differences for this new model, so I'll go through them, but I'll go through everything anyway. So to get started, sometimes you see these yellow and red things on top of buttons, right? What do they mean? Well, if you want to type this pi, for example, which is yellow, you have to press shift and then press this button, which the pi is underneath, and you can see that the pi has been typed. Similarly, for the red colored E, you have to press alpha instead. Press it and then press this, and an E has appeared. So that's how you type these yellow and red things. And as you can see, the letters A to F are here in red, and so you can just type them A, B, C, D, E, and F. That's six of them done. Also, there's an alternate E which I just showed you just now. E, and there's also, you see NCR? That's actually a C. It's a thick C. That's thick with two C's. Haha. If you want to understand that, you can, I mean, like, it's from the comments on my old video. Which, did I say this? It has 1,000 likes, so thanks a lot for that. I know it also has 200 likes. Yeah, I know my old videos were a bit beating around the bush. I'll try not to do that. Alright, so we've done A to F. How to type G? Well, this is different because now there's an option button and you have to press that, then press 2 for angle unit. When you see this kind of menus, right, you have to press 2 to select. You have to press a number to select, I mean. So, for example, you see there's a G here. There's a degree sign, an R, and a G. They actually stand for degrees, radians, and gradients, but you don't have to worry about that. So you just want to type in G, which is here. So you press 3. Ta-da, you have a G. That's a G. It's kind of okay. It's a G. It's very small compared to like the A, but that's the G. Alright, to type H, you press this button, which is absolute value, and the absolute value sign pops up. Then you press a minus. That's H. For I, you just press this button, which is the factorial symbol. For j, you can press the close bracket, and for k, you can press the open bracket and put the cursor before it. This is a problem if you have to type multiple k's because there's only one cursor, so you can just put an exclamation mark or the sorry factorial symbol. That's kind of a K, but it's not as good. Alright, for L it's 1, because 1 kind of looks more like an L than a I, like the cursive L, you know? Yeah. And M is here. See? It's red, so you press alpha and then M plus, and you have an M. For N, the closest you've got is a pi, so you have to type that. O is 0. P is NPR, which is shift times. Q is 0, then a dot. It's the closest there is. R is that menu, option 2. R is here, so you select 2. S is 5. T is a plus, U is two brackets. Doesn't even look. V is a double. V is a sorry. V is a square root, and W is two square roots. Doesn't even look like a W, does it? Yeah, I mean it's not. It's a calculator. It's not meant to type letters, and these are all just hacks. Hacks with an X, which very nicely brings us to X, which is here. Shift close bracket. Y is shift S arrow D and Z is just the 2. Alright, so that's the alphabet. Now you can type things like Singapore. Oh, yeah, you can type 9 for a G if you know, if that works better. There we go, Singapore. Or you can just, instead of using 5 exclamation mark pi, you can just press sign. Yeah, kind of cool. Alright, so actually, there are other modes you can go into with other letters. For example, if you press setup and you have this menu, you press 2, then you press option, you will have this menu, and when you scroll down by pressing the down arrow, you have D, B, H, and O. So those can be typed, but this is in the base N setting. Now, if you want to go into the statistics mode and just press 1 and AC to get into the typing place, you press option, scroll down, and press summation. You have these two choices. You can press variable, you have these choices. You can press min-max. Well, I'm not sure if you'd want to type those very often. Norm, dist, PQR in caps, and a T. Yeah, so those are what you can do in statistics. And to return to back to normal mode, you press menu in 1. So, those are the letters on the calculator. I will see you next time, where I will introduce something else to you.